Everybody, welcome back to another video. It's your boy Jay Bird, aka Mr. Cool Guy. But with this video, I'm reviewing J-Lo's third album that came out 20 years ago, and it was the year 2002, called This Is Me Then. I gotta say, this is a classic album by Jennifer Lopez, released around 2002. It's got like a lot of hip-hop, soul, R&B, Latino, and pop. There's about four singles off the album, such as Jenny from the Block, All I Have, I'm Glad, Baby I Love You. And it's good that she has some interesting producers on, helping her make this album a smash hit. And the record is pretty much throwback materials, which inspires hip-hop, pop, music. And during the production, Jennifer Lopez was inspired by the work of Michael Jackson, Luther Vandross, Stevie Wonder, and among more. And we're going to review all 11 tracks on this album by Jennifer Lopez, starting with track one, Still. Here we go, guys. Say track one, Still. That's an interesting joint. It's do got like a lot of R&B and soul and pop coming together, and it's good. I got a chance to check the song out when it was the year 2008, and you all can tell me like we got like about track one, Still. Is that one of the interesting songs that she did to begin the record with? Let me know your thoughts. All right, moving on, track two, Loving You. Here we go, guys. Thank you. Yeah, that song isn't too bad though. You know, she sampled a classic called Juicy Fruit. I don't know the person's name though, but I actually feel that song is interesting. And I don't know if it was her that was singing the background vocals, but it had to have been another singer in the background vocals though. But you all can tell me like what y'all like about track two. Is that one of the interesting songs that she did, or y'all just like how that song is an amazing joint on the record? Y'all just can't get enough of it. Alright, moving on. Track 3. Single off the album, I'm Glad. Here we go, guys. Sorry. Seen the video. The video was excellent with her doing ballet and, you know, being an exotic dancer in the video as well. And this song do got like a lot of R&B, and I actually feel that. And you all could tell me like what y'all like about track 3. Is that one of the best songs that's still a single off the record? Y'all just like that's an interesting classic to listen to while playing the whole entire record? Let me know your thoughts. Alright, moving on, track 4, The One. Here we go, guys. Thank you. that song, track four, The One. I actually feel that song. It got like a lot of R&B, and may I say Jennifer Lopez did go with that song. And I know that Corey Ronnie co-written that song. It's with J-Lo, and I know that it was some background vocalists in this song, such as Billy Lawrence, Corey Ronnie, and Natasha Rosie. And I say that song is pretty touchy. I really like it, and it's a joyful song to listen to. And I just like how that beat is, and I really like them lyrics that she was singing. And of course, was amazing. Y'all could tell me, like, we got like about track four, The One. Is that one of the best songs that she did on the record? One of the interesting songs that you can't get enough of listening to? Let me know your thoughts. All right, moving on to track five, Dear Ben. Here we go, guys. J-Lo written the song dedicating it to Ben Affleck at that time when they were dating, like when it was the year 2002, and they got engaged in November 2002. And the title Dear Ben was originally titled Perfect, but it's good that she dedicated that song to Ben Affleck, expressing her love towards him at that time to the media. And I say that is a joyful song, and I really like all that R&B and soul coming together with this song, and it's amazing. And you all could tell me, like, we all like about track five, Dear Ben. Is that one of the joyful songs that she dedicated to the actor Ben Affleck? Please share. All right, moving on, track six, single off the album All I Have featuring LL Cool J. Here we go. Nothing like being left behind.
like this. I don't believe I just had my last real kiss. I do believe we'll laugh and reminisce. Wait a minute, don't bounce, baby. Let's talk about this, man.
Well, I'm bouncing and I'm bouncing. I gotta leave you alone, cause I'm good. Holding down my spot and I'm good. Repping the girls on your block and I'm good. I got this thing on lock, so without me you'll be fine, right? All my pride is all I have.
Pride is what you had, baby girl, I'm what you have.
You'll be needing me, but too bad.
Be easy, don't make decisions when you're mad.
The path you chose to run alone.
I know you're independent, you can make it on your own.
Here with me, I have a home.
My time is up and this is why I spend it alone. I was creeping all over town. Lord, my tender touch could lock you down. I knew I had you, as cocky as it sounds. Like the way you used to giggle right before I put it down. It's better when you make me come in, I'll prove it now. Come in.
Stop playing, oh, you make it. I gotta leave you alone. I'm good, holding down my spot, and I'm good. Repping the curve on the block, and I'm good.
Instead of beefing, come hold me. I promise I'm not a phony. Don't bounce, baby, console me. Come in.
Nothing you can say to me that can change my mind. I gotta let you go now.
Now, I gotta say, track 6, All I Have featuring LL Cool J. I really like that it's a smash hit off her record. And I know it was featured on LL Cool J's album, 10. And I gotta say, it was a perfect, song that they did together about moving on after a breakup and, you know, just start fresh. And I know it's about like working things out, but the next partner don't want to do that. She just want to move on and not deal with the same mess that she dealt with before. And this song do like a lot of pop, hip-hop, and R&B. And you all could tell me like we all like about track 6, that one of the best songs that she did with a legend such as LL Cool J. Please share. Alright, moving on. Track 7, single off the album, Jenny from the Block, featuring Styles P and Jadakiss. Here we go, y'all.
Children growing up with men using men, go work inside the steel. Everyone's got to make a living.
Hello, back here. This year,
went from a low to a lot this year.
Everybody mad at the rocks that I wear.
I know where I'm going and I know where I'm from. You hear locks in the air.
Yeah, we at the airport out. D-block from the block where everybody Air Force out.
With a new white tee, you fresh. None phony with us. Make the money, get the mansion, bring the homies with us.
By the rocks that I got, I'm still Jenny from the block.
I've grown up so much, I'm in control and loving it.
rocks, then I got the assets to get back what you put out. Even if you take the good route, can't count the hood out. After a while, you'll know who you blend with. Just keep it real with the brothers you came in with.
Best thing to do is stay low. Docs and J-Los, act like they don't know what they know.
I'm still Jenny from the block. Used to have a little, now I have a lot. No matter where I go, I know where I came from.
Now I gotta say, track 7, Jenny from the Block, track master remix featuring Jadakiss and Styles P. I gotta say that is a dope single off the album, and I seen the video was featuring her and Ben Affleck in the video, and this song do like a lot of R&B, hip hop, and pop come together, and it's good. I got a chance to check this song out when it was the year 2003, and she did good with that track, and I really like that. It's a smash hit off the record. You walk and let me know like how much y'all love that song by J-Lo. Is it one of her best songs that's off the record? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Alright, moving on, track 8 again. Here we go, guys. Track 8 again. That song is very touchy, though. I really like that. It's got like a lot of R&B and soul coming together with pop melodies and bald bass coming together. And this basically about J-Lo consider finding love again and was scared to let go and trust your love, as she said in the second verse. And that is a very joyful song that I ever heard on the record. And you all can tell me like what y'all like about that song. Is it one of the interesting songs that she did on the record? Y'all just like that. It's got like a lot of R&B, soul, and ball coming together. Please share. All right, moving on. Track 9, You Belong to Me. Here we go, guys. Go by the name of Kylie Simon. Carly Simon, wherever her name is. But other than that, the song is pretty good though, and it's nice that she did her own cover up to the joint though. And it do got like a lot of pop and a little bit of funkness. Yeah, I said she did a good cover up to that song, and you all can tell me like what y'all like about track 9. Y'all like that she did a cover up to the classic joint by Carly Simon. Please share. Alright, moving on. Track 10, Been Thinking. Here we go, guys.
A chance to know the thoughts and find a way to show.
say track 10, I've Been Thinking. That's a very joyful song. It's got like a lot of R&B and soul and pop coming together. And I really feel her unique singing voice as she sings every verse, and the vocals are incredible. And you all can let me know like what y'all like about track 10, The Comments Below. Is that one of the interesting songs that y'all ever heard on this record or not? Let me know how good it is to you guys. All right, moving on. Track 11, single off the album, Baby I Love You. Here we go, guys. Track 11, Baby I Love You. That's an interesting song. I really feel that R&B and pop, also soul melodies coming together. I said that's an excellent love song on the record, and she did go with that track, and I can't lie, it is an interesting song that I got to check out when it was the year 2003. And you all can tell me like what y'all like about track 11, single off the album, Baby I Love You. Alright, moving on, track 12, final track of the album, which is the bonus track called The One Volume 2. Here we go, or version 2.
Thank you.
say track 12, the one, version 2. That version was good too. It was good as the first version. I can't tell which one I like better. I pretty much vibe with both of them, but I gotta say this is good that she put this as a bonus track to close the record with. And this song do like a lot of hip hop, R&B, and soul. And she did sample a classic in here. You Are My Everything by a group I never heard of. And I really feel her unique singing voice as she sing the verses and, you know, just do what she do when it comes to making good music. And y'all can tell me like what y'all like about track 12, the bonus track called The One, version 2. Is it better than the previous version? Y'all like that version better? Let me know your thoughts. Well, that's a wrap, everybody. We just reviewed all 12 tracks on this third album by J-Lo called This Is Me Then. Now I say this album is a classic, and this album is pretty much is an inspiration to her relationship that she had with Ben Affleck when they were dating when it was the year 2002. And I really like that. This album do serve as her inspiration to her relationship with Ben Affleck, and it's also a dedication to him. And I really enjoy all the smash hits off the record, such as Jenny from the Block, All I Have, I'm Glad, Baby, I Love You. And the album do like a lot of hip-hop, soul, R&B, pop, dance, and among more. And I get this album 100 stars, and I really like that she had guest appearances from Jadakiss, Styles P, and LL Cool J. And the album did debut at number 2 on the charts, but it was number 5 for top R&B / hip hop album. And it's good that the album went 2 times platinum, selling like 200,000 and 600,000 copies. It's 600,000 copies worldwide, and this is a smash hit that J-Lo did 20 years ago, and it was the year 2002. And you all can let me know, like, is this still one of her best albums to this day? Even though it was the 20th anniversary of this album when it was the year 2022. And she did release a sequel to this album called This Is Me Now, her newest album that came out this year. But I will be reviewing that record soon, so y'all look out for me reviewing her 9th album that came out this year called This Is Me Now. And y'all can let me know like what y'all favorite tracks off of this album by Jennifer Lopez in the comments below. Please share. Well, this is your boy Jay Bird, aka Mr. Cool Guy. That was my album review by Jennifer Lopez, reviewing her third album that came out when it was the year 2002, called This Is Me Then. This album is pretty good, and I really enjoy all the songs, and she got a unique singing voice, and I'm glad I got a chance to check this album out when I was a kid. Feel free to hit that subscribe button, tune to my later videos, check out for more upcoming videos, give me a thumbs up if you like this video, and I'll see you guys next time. So, peace out, y'all take it easy, like and subscribe to my channel, and deuces.